Greetings to you in the name of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ, and I want to give glory to God for what God has been doing in each one of our lives. Today I want to declare about the power of God, because we need to know that the power of God is very much important in our lives, that without the power of God, we can be defeated. And that's why during this pandemic, we need to know that we need to come close to God more and more as ever before, because we have a common enemy, and that's the devil. And that's where we need to know one thing, my brother and sister, today, that without the power of God, you can be defeated in this world. Hallelujah. Because the book of Isaiah chapter 10 verse 27 says, the yoke shall be broken because of the anointing oil. In Isaiah 10 verse 27, the Bible says, for the yoke shall be broken because of the anointing oil. The devil is the one who puts a yoke upon each one of our lives. And that's why today God has anointed us, just like in Acts chapter 1:8. The Bible says that you will attain power when the Holy Ghost shall come upon you, and then you shall be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the entire universe. And that's why for you to be effective and you want to win back everything that what the enemy has stolen, you need the power of God to operate in our lives. And that's very much important, my brother and sister in Christ, that without the power of God, you can be defeated. And that's where Jesus Christ demonstrated the power of God, not only in his ministry, but also they were able to be demonstrated in the life of the disciples. They were ordinary people, they were ordinary fishermen. They had no form of education, they had no form of studies, they never went to university, they never went to college. But one thing they had the Holy Spirit, which God has promised in his word, that the Holy Spirit shall be with you, it shall abide in you, and it shall lead you into all truth. And that's very much important, my brother and sister in Christ. And that's what we need to know, that when we call upon the name of God, you will see the power of God operating in our lives. And that's very much important today, as I want to preach about the word of God. The Bible says in Daniel chapter 11 verse 32, for the yoke shall be broken because of the anointing oil. And that's what you need to know clearly, that God has anointed each one of us with a plan and a purpose. You may be big, you may be small, you may be young, you may be old, it does not matter to God, as long as you operate in the power of God. Because God does not look at your personality, God does not look at your qualification, God does not look at your outward appearance, but God looks into your heart. The Bible says in 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 7, for man look at the outward appearance, but I the God who looks into the heart. The Bible says, for much is given, much is required. When you spend time with God, God will anoint you, and you can do a very powerful ministry, because ministry is very much important in the work of God. Winning of souls is very much important, because the greatest priority for every human being, the greatest priority for every human being on this planet Earth is to win souls. Hallelujah. And that's for the greatest commission that Jesus has given to each one of us. That's why when he has saved you, he has called you, he has anointed you with a great plan and a purpose. And that's what you need to understand, my brother and sister in Christ today, that when God has called you with a plan and a purpose, you need to be obedient to the calling. For many are called, but only few are choosing to do his will. And that's what very much important for you and for me to know. And that's why he has anointed you with his Holy Spirit. He has anointed you with his power, that you may destroy the work of the devil. Because the Bible says in the book of 1 John chapter 4 verse 8, it says, for greater is he who is in me than he who is in the world. And that's where the Holy Spirit is given to you as a deposit. He has been given to you as a guarantee. He has sealed you with his Holy Spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. And that's why you require the fire baptism. The fire baptism is the one which will destroy and dismantle every power of darkness. You will dismantle the power of darkness, because the world is full of evil, wherever there is wickedness. Because the Bible says in 1 John chapter 5 verse 19, he says the whole world is under the snare of the devil. The Bible says in John 10:10, for the thief come to kill, to steal, and to destroy, but I have come to give you life in life and abundance. That's the way for the yoke to be broken. That's where today we can see that the enemy is putting many people into slavery. He's putting into many bondages, and that's what many people are getting defeated. Because one thing you need to understand, That Jesus Christ was not defeated on the cross of Calvary. Because when he went to the cross, it was victory. Amen. And through the power of the resurrection, that he was able to conquer over not only heaven, earth, but under the earth. And that's what Jesus Christ said, that all power in heaven, in earth, and under the earth has been given to me by my Father. And that's very much important, my brother and sister in Christ, that today Jesus wants you also to have the same power. He wants you to have the same authority. He wants you to dominate over everything in your life. And that's where today, when you call upon the name of Jesus, when you tell him to anoint, he will anoint you with his power and will use you as a mighty weapon in his hand. That's where you need to be obedient to the calling for which call. When you start spending time in his presence, hallelujah, he will anoint you with the power of the Holy Spirit, and you can be very powerfully used by God, hallelujah. And you can win souls for the Lord, hallelujah. Your ministry will be with signs, wonders, and miracles. Healing will take place. Deliverance will take place. Prophetic, you will speak the Rhema word and it will come to pass. Hallelujah. The Bible says when you decree and declare a thing, and it shall come to pass. Hallelujah. And that's what, when you declare, there will be power in your word. That's where you have to be anointed. That's what God used ordinary men. God used ordinary men to do the extraordinary. Today, if you are willing to be yielded by the Holy Spirit, if you are ready to be broken, God can use you in a mighty way like never before. Hallelujah. You have to be broken, because he will break you, he will melt you, he will mold you, and he will fill you with his power. And when the power of God comes, no one can stand before you. That's what Paul was able to say, that we are more in conquerors in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Because that's how the disciples may be able to use powerfully by God, because they believed in God, they believed in the power of the Holy Spirit. And today, God doesn't want you, my brother and sister, that you be ignorant, that you be ignorant of the power of God. It's only the devil that makes you ignorant of the power of God, because when the power of God comes, you will defeat him, you will move with the great power, hallelujah. And that's very much important, my brother and sister in Christ. And that's very much important for you to be baptized with the Holy Spirit, hallelujah. Many people say, oh, I have been filled with the Holy Spirit. Oh, I have already have the Holy Spirit. Having the Holy Spirit when you get born again is one experience, but being baptized in the Holy Spirit is a different experience. It takes you to the next level. It takes you from one anointing to another anointing. It takes you from one glory to another glory. And that's what you need to understand, that God has chosen ordinary people. And that's what Jesus did to the disciples who gathered in the upper room on the day of Pentecost. When they received the Holy Spirit, the power of God came. They went into the synagogue. They went into the synagogue declaring the word of God. That's where we say that Peter gave the first sermon. And his sermon, there were 3,000 souls that were added. Hallelujah. And how great signs, wonders, and miracles were done, my brother and sister in Christ. And that's the same Jesus who same yesterday, today, and forever is the same Jesus who can change your life. He can change your finances. He can heal you of your sickness. He can heal you of your disease. He can heal you of whatever type of viruses you may be having. No matter what the doctor has been telling about you. But when you believe in Jesus, when you believe in the power of God, the Bible says no sickness shall come towards you, no evil shall befall you. The word of God has given us a powerful promise. It says that the sickness that came, or the disease that came upon the Egyptian, they shall not come on you, for I am the Lord that healeth thee. That's where when you have the power of God, you can be into the healing ministry. You can be into the deliverance ministry. When you start praying, you will see evil spirits coming out, crying out in the name of Jesus. You can move into the prophetic realm. Hallelujah. When you move the prophet, there will be a word. There will be a Rhema word for you, that God will tell you what. Because in the prophetic, God gives you direction. God tells you what to do and what not to do. And that's why one of the greatest gifts in the body of Christ is the gift of prophecy. Because the gift of prophecy gives you direction. It tells you what to do and what not to do. Who to marry, which job to do, and what to do at what time. That's why you need to be led by the Spirit of God. The Bible says, for those who led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. For that you need to spend time in the presence of God. You need to be ministered by the Lord. That's what Moses had to be ministered for 40 days before the power of God came upon him. Before the glory of God came upon Moses, he had to be ministered on Mount Sinai. After 40 days of fasting and praying and separating himself to be ministered by the Lord, the Bible says that the glory of God was seen upon Moses that the Israelites were not able to see his face, because he reflected the glory of God, because his face was radiant. Hallelujah. The Bible says, for those who look upon the Lord, they shall be radiant. And that's what happened to Moses, and with that God was able to deliver the Israelites who were in bondage for 430 years to a single man. Because today the Bible says God is looking for a man like you and me. In the book of Ezekiel chapter 22 verse 30, the Lord is saying that I am looking for a man, I am looking for a woman that will stand in the gap, that will declare the word of God. Today, just like how we use Moses, God can use you when you surrender your life to God, when you start spending time in the presence of God, when you start listening to the voice of God, the anointing of God will come upon you in a mighty way like never before. You will pray and people will be saved. You will pray and people will be healed. You will pray and people will be delivered from every power of darkness, from every witchcraft. Because the Bible says, for no weapon formed against you shall prosper. In Isaiah 54 verse 17, the Bible says, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Any hand that rises against you in judgment, it shall be condemned. That's what the word of God. The Bible says, for there is no witchcraft, no sorcery against you. That's the greatest promise, because the power of God is greater than the power of the devil. And that's what God wants to anoint you. That's why today you must not be ignorant of the power of God. You must not be ignorant of the power of God. My brother, my sister, it's only the devil who makes you ignorant of the power of God. He says, oh, you can read your Bible, you can worship God, you can praise God, you can pray. He doesn't want you to have that power, because when you have that power, you will move into the supernatural. You will move into another realm, my brother, my sister. And the devil doesn't want you to trample him under your feet. That's what the Bible says, because God's promise is given that we must trample Satan under our feet. In Romans chapter 16 verse 20, the Bible says, for the Prince of Peace shall trample Satan under your feet. That means the power has been, because he was already defeated on the cross when Jesus Christ died on the cross. Jesus defeated him when he died on the cross, and today Jesus has given you the power to trample over the enemy, my brother and sister in Christ. And that's the way today the devil doesn't want you to have the power of God. He doesn't want you to have the power of God, because when you have the power of God, because when you know who you are in Christ, you will defeat the enemy. You will defeat your problem. You will defeat your pain. You will defeat your sickness. You will defeat even your finances. Whatever the enemy has stolen, he will restore back when you have the power of God. Is that what God can restore? Everything, the whatever you lost, even in this pandemic, even in this coronavirus, the people are confused. They do not know what to do. They do not know where to go and what to do. They do not have direction, my brother, my sister in Christ. And that's why you need a prophetic word. That's why you need a rhema word from the Lord, that God is there with you. Because the Bible says he has never left you, nor will he forsake you. He is not a man that he will leave you nor forsake you. Your people will leave you. Your relatives will leave you. Your family members will leave you. Every person who you trust may leave you. But God said, I will never leave you. He's just looking for you. He is looking at you. His eyes are always upon you. 2 Chronicles chapter 69, he says, my eyes run through and fro towards the face of the earth to look for a man. God is looking for you, my brother. God is searching for you. Just like we were searching for Adam and Eve. The Bible says when Adam and Eve sinned against God, they were hiding themselves from the presence of God. He came in search because why? Because God had everyday communion. He had intimacy with Adam and Eve. He had fellowship and he was longing. But because Adam and Eve sinned against God by disobeying God, they hid from the presence of God. And today God is looking. Today God is looking for you, my brother. God is looking for you, my sister. Are you ready? Are you ready to do the work of God? Are you ready to be anointed by God? Because God's power is there. It's given to you freely. The Bible says freely you will give and freely you will receive. And that's what the Holy Spirit has been given to us freely. The gift of the Holy Spirit has been given to us freely, that we may minister to the church. Hallelujah. And that's why, my brother and sister in Christ, amen, that when you have the gift of the Holy Spirit, you, amen, can operate in a different dimension. You can know the mind of God. You can know the mind of God. That's why Philippians chapter 2:5, let us have the mind of God. And that's what the Bible says clearly in the book of Revelation 3 verse 7, for he who has a ear, let him listen to what the Spirit of the Lord says. For if you have a ear, you must be sensitive to the power of the Holy Spirit. You must be sensitive to do what God has called you to do, my brother and sister in Christ. The Bible says in the book of Matthew 6:33, seek the kingdom of God and my righteousness, and all these things shall be added above our earth, shall be added unto you. My brother and sister, whoever is watching this video live today, the Lord is speaking that he has not forgotten you. He has not forgotten you, my brother and sister in Christ. He's going to do a great and mighty thing. When you start spending time in the presence of God, when you start spending time in the presence of God, you can see the hand of God. He is your provider. He will provide even food for you on the table. If God was able to provide for 40 years in the wilderness, he fed them with manna and quail. This is not the same God who can feed you, my brother and sister in Christ. He can feed you, my brother. You don't have to worry. You don't have to commit suicide. You don't have to think what is going to happen. Let your trust be upon God. Let your trust be upon God and not upon man, not upon the government, not upon what people say, but let your trust be upon the word of God. Meditate upon the word of God day and night, because God is in the business of speaking to his people. That's why during this pandemic, when you have time, spend time in the presence of God. Lord, ask you whatever you ask in my name. The Bible says, whatever you ask in my name, I will do it. That's what the Bible says. Whatever you ask in my name, I will give it. That's what the Bible says in John chapter 14 verse 14. The Bible clearly says that you need to ask, hallelujah, because he is your heavenly father. You have a legal right to ask the heavenly father. He is your provider. He is Jehovah Jireh. He has not forgotten you. He is your banner. He is your Jehovah Shammah. He is your healer. That's why whatever may be a problem today, my brother and sister, does not matter. Because in the eyes of God, all things are possible. The Bible says, behold, I am the Lord God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me? Jeremiah 32 verse 27 says, behold, I am the Lord God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard? Nothing is impossible to God, my brother, my sister in Christ. In Mark 11, 24, the Bible says, whatever you ask in prayer, if you believe it, you have received it. That's why you require a faith. Because you require a measure of faith. You require to believe. You have to believe, though you may not see, but you must still believe. And that's what God is looking for you, my brother and sister in Christ. It's only your faith that can move every mountain. It's only your faith that can change your situation, your circumstance. And that's why you must have faith. And that's what Jesus Christ said, that if you have faith, as the mustard said, if you command this mountain to go and fall into the sea, it will fall, my brother and sister in Christ. It is your faith that moves the heart of God. It is only the faith that you can operate in the kingdom of God. You do not need money, because in the secular world you need money, but in the kingdom of God you require faith in believing that God can manifest in a supernatural way. He can manifest in your finance. He can manifest in your family. He can do great and mighty things. The Bible says great and mighty things you will do. The Bible clearly, God has promised that the things that I do, greater things than these you will do. In John chapter 14 verse 12, the Bible says, the things that I do, great and mighty things, and greater things than these, greater things are about to come, my brother, my sister. As you prepare yourself in meeting God, as you prepare yourself to have an encounter with the Holy Spirit, because when you have an encounter with the Holy Spirit, your life will be totally changed. Your life will be totally transformed. You will become like Moses, who was an humble man. Hallelujah. The Bible says that when he had an encounter with God at Mount Sinai, his life was totally changed and transformed. The glory of God came upon me, my brother. Just like how the disciples, when they had an encounter with the Holy Spirit on the day of Pentecost, their lives were totally changed. Their lives were totally transformed into the image and into the likeness of God. That wherever they went, the great signs, wonders and miracles were done through these apostles, through these disciples who had no form of education, who never went to Bible school, who never had any form of theology, but they had one of the greatest teachers. And who was the greatest teacher that they had? It was the Holy Spirit, my brother and sister in Christ. And today, God is speaking to you in this live video today. I do not know how many people are watching, but there is a message from the Lord, that the Lord has not forsaken you, for the Lord will not forget. forsake you. Though people may forsake you, he said, I will never leave you, nor will I forsake you. Why? Because he is your heavenly father. He is a friend that lives closer than a brother. That's why the Bible says, on that day I do not call you servant, but I call you friend. And he is a friend that lives closer than a brother. The Bible says in the book of James chapter 2 verse 23, that Abraham was a friend of God. Hallelujah. That's how you need to speak, like one friend speak to another friend. That is how the relationship you share with God. My brother and sister in Christ, you need to open out your heart unto the Lord. When you open out your heart unto the Lord, God will tell you what to do. That's why you need to be led by the Spirit of God. You need to be moved by the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Because it's the same Spirit that raised Jesus Christ from the dead. The Bible says it's the same Spirit that is dwelling inside your mortal body. My brother and sister in Christ, and today, do not worry. Do not fear. Let not fear come into you. The Bible says, fear not, O little flock. It's the will of God that to give you the kingdom. Hallelujah. Fear not. Do not be dismayed for what is happening at the moment because of this coronavirus. Let not fear take control over your life, because fear is the greatest weapon from the devil, my brother and sister in Christ. And God wants you to have faith. God wants you to have faith as a mustard seed, because fear does not come from God. It is the one put by the devil. Insecurity does not come from God. Because that's what you need. Sickness does not come from God. Virus does not come from God. God has given you power over everything that he has created. That's why in Genesis chapter 1 verse 26, when he created man in his image and his likeness, he says, have dominion over everything that I have created. He has given us the power and the authority over everything, even over this creation, even over the devil. Jesus has given us the power over the devil, over the creation. You speak the word and it shall come. There is power in the word. The Bible says, for life and death is in the power of the tongue. What you speak is what, that's what happened. Even in the book of Joshua, clearly, when they were fighting a battle, clearly, the Lord said to Joshua, speak a rhema. He said, speak to the sun, speak to the moon. When he spoke, the Bible says that the sun did not move until they won the battle. That's what happened even in when Elijah prayed. Even when Elijah said, at the word of the Lord, let it not rain. For 3.5 years, it did not rain, my brother. At the command of word of God, he said, let fire come down from heaven. Fire came down and burned the sacrifice, because there is power. They were just ordinary people like you and me. They were ordinary men, because the Lord has chosen ordinary people to do the extraordinary things. That's what, when you start believing in the name of Jesus, when you start believing in the name of Jesus, you need to ask yourself today, Lord, I want to be anointed. I want to be anointed like you, just like even Jesus had to be anointed. Acts chapter 10 verse 38 says, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the power of the Holy Spirit, that he started to heal the sick and deliver those who are being afflicted by the devil, for God was with him. That's where Jesus also, though being the Son of God, though Jesus being born of the Holy Spirit, he had to be anointed by God to do a powerful and effective ministry. Today, my brother and sister, today you may be a pastor, today you may be an evangelist, today you may be a bishop, no matter what may be your calling, no matter what your title may be. Today you need the power of God. Hallelujah. Because God does not show partiality. God does not show favoritism. God looks into your heart. God looks into your heart. The Bible says, take delight in the law, and I will give you the desire of God. Today, what may be your desire? What is your desire? Is your desire to win souls? Is your desire to operate in the power of God? What is your desire today, my brother and sister in Christ? When you desire God, when you desire the King, he will provide for you everything. You need to desire the King. You need to desire the King, my brother, my sister. When you desire him, he will provide everything. Even what you do not ask, he will give, my brother and sister in Christ. And that's what today the Lord is enabling us to. God is saying, fear not. Fear not, my brother. Fear not, my sister. For God is in control of every situation and circumstance. He has not forsaken you. He will never leave you nor forsake you, my brother, my sister in Christ. He is always there with you, 24 hours into 7 into 365 days. And that's why his Holy Spirit is dwelling inside us. That's why his anointing is dwelling inside us. And that's why the devil fears the anointing of God. He doesn't want you to be anointed by the Holy Spirit. Yeah. He doesn't want you to have the power of God. Because when you have the power of God, you can break every plan of the devil. You can dismantle principalities, powers, and spiritual wickedness which you cannot see. Because we are not dealing with an enemy that can be seen. We are dealing with an enemy that is unseen in our eyes, my brother and sister. Because you need to understand that Satan is not a man. Satan is a spirit. And there are evil spirits which you cannot see. But one thing, God has given you the power to destroy. That's why the Bible says in Daniel 11:34, for those who know the Bible, for those who know God, they will do great exploits. Amen. They will do great exploits only for those who know God. Only for those who know God only can be used effectively by God. Hallelujah. And that's why for you to know God, yes, you need to spend time in the presence of God. You need to hear to His voice. You must be sensitive to the Holy Spirit. When you are sensitive to the Holy Spirit, God can use you, my brother, my thing. Because much is given, much is required from you. You need to separate yourself. You need to separate yourself from your family members. You need to separate yourself from your friends. You need to separate yourself from this world, what is happening. Because you have to spend time so that you must be ready to be ministered by the Lord. If you are not ministered by the Lord, I'll tell you, you can never minister to people. That's why it's very much important for you to be ministered. The Bible says that Moses had to be ministered by God for 40 days before he could lead the children from Egypt. And that's what clearly the Bible says, when he was humbled himself in being ministered by the Lord, you know what happened? God used him as a mighty deliverer. He was able to deliver the children of Israel who were into bondage, into slavery for 430 years. That's what, when you are ministered by the Lord, God can deliver you from every bondage, from every slavery, from every witchcraft power, or whatever may be a financial problem. God will deliver you and God will give you everything that whatever He has promised you. Because He is not a man that He should lie. The Bible says in the book of Numbers 23:19 that He is not a man that He should lie. He is a God who cannot lie, because He is the way, the life, and the truth. But the greatest miracle is salvation. Today, if you have not accepted the Lord, it's time for you to come to the Lord, because we are living in the most dangerous times of life. Yeah. Everything what we are seeing today, every day we see what is happening with the coronavirus. It is increasing. It is killing people. Whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are a millionaire, whether you are whatever you may be, whatever your position, whatever power you may have. But in the eyes of God, you are nothing. Because only life and death is in the hands of God. Yes. That's why if you have not accepted Jesus as the Lord and Savior, it is time for you to accept Him as the Lord and the Savior. Because this is the day of salvation which God has. Because the greatest miracle is salvation. Because without salvation, no one makes it. Life is not guaranteed, my brother, my sister. Today you may be seeing this live program, but tomorrow we do not know what is going to happen. That's what even Jesus said in His word. Do not worry of tomorrow. Let tomorrow worry itself. Clearly, my brother and sister, it is time for you to know the Lord. It is time for you to get baptized and believe in the name of God, my brother, that when you die, that you will be in heaven and that you will not be left off. Hallelujah! Because Jesus Christ has already prepared a place for each one of us. That's why the Bible says, unless one is born of water and spirit, he will not enter the kingdom of God. No matter, my brother, your money cannot take you to heaven. Your family cannot take you to heaven. Nothing in this planet earth can take you to heaven. It's only Jesus who can take you to heaven. And that's why you have to be saved. You have to be born again with the water and the spirit. Amen. And that's what, when you accept Jesus Christ as the Lord and His Savior, that's when your name shall be written in the book of life. Amen. It's not only just being born again. You must have the desire to be anointed by God. You must have the desire to have the power of God operating in your life, my brother and sister. That's when you know. That's when you get the power of God operating in your life. You will be victorious in everything that you do. Every part of your life, you will be victorious. You will not be defeated. Because God doesn't want you to be defeated. Because Jesus Himself was not defeated at the cross. It was victory for Jesus Christ when He rose from the dead. And that's why He says, all power in heaven and earth and under the earth has been given to me by my Father. And that's what you have lost. The Bible says that God will give you back. He will give you back a double portion of whatever you have lost. Just like he was able to restore the losses to who? To Job. The Bible says in 42 verse 10 that when Job prayed for his friends, God restored him. Double portion. In the book of Zechariah chapter 9 verse 12, he says, prisoners of hope, for I will restore you a double portion. He will restore everything that what the devil has stolen from you, my brother, my because he is the Prince of Peace. So let not fear enter into your heart, but believe in the promise of God. Meditate upon the word of God. Pray daily. Be anointed. Have communion with God. Have fellowship with God. Have intimacy with God. For God is in the business of doing great things in your life. Amen. God is in the business of doing great and mighty things he will do. Amen. Hallelujah. He will raise a table before your enemy. That's what the Bible clearly says. That's how David was lifted up. David was just an ordinary shepherd. He was ignored by his family member. He was not even a soldier in the army of King Saul. He was a person who was totally rejected by his family. He was rejected by his relatives. He was rejected by his friends. But he was accepted by God. Because if you are accepted by God, God will change your story. Everyone on this planet Earth has a story. Even Joseph had a story. Even Esther had a story. Even David has a story to tell. That's what David was rejected by the King Saul's army. He was not able to go and become a soldier in the army of King Saul. But he was accepted by God. He spent time in the presence of God. He spent time in the presence of God. And when the time came, God lifted him up and took him to the palace. That's where we see that God made David the king, my brother and sister in Christ. There will be a time and a season. And that season when it comes, God will lift you up. The Bible says the word of the Lord came to test him in the prison. The Bible says in Psalm 105, to Joseph clearly, the word of God says that the word of the Lord came and tested him. And when the word of the Lord came and tested him, God lifted him up from a prison and took him to the palace where he became the prime minister of Egypt. Joseph was just an ordinary man. Esther was just an ordinary slave girl. Today you may be thinking as a girl, I'm useless. Can God use me? Can I be used for the kingdom of God? Let me tell you, my sister, today, that God does not show partiality. God does not show favoritism. Because Acts chapter 10, 34 says, he does not show partiality, nor does he show favoritism. He looks into your heart. He looks into your heart. If your heart is ready, you can be used as a mighty woman like Deborah. When the king was not ready to do the work of God, immediately he changed position God. And who did he choose? He chose Deborah. Deborah was used as a mighty prophetess. She was the judge who ruled for 40 years over Israel. Why? Because man was not ready to do the work of God. When a man is not ready to do the work of God, God uses a woman. And when a woman disobeys God, God will use an animal. Like how we use the donkey to shame the prophet Bilam or Balaam. That's what my brother and sister in Christ. Do not lose hope. Because the Bible says hope does not disappoint us. The Bible says hope does not disappoint us. In the book of Romans chapter 5 verse 5, the Bible says hope does not disappoint us. For God's love has been poured through the Holy Spirit. And the word of God says in Proverbs 23:18, for your hope shall not be cut off. Your hope shall not be cut off. Your hope, if it is in God, it will not be cut off. It will surely come to pass. If today you have received a rhema word, if today you have received a prophetic word, if today you have received a promise, meditate upon the promise. For in due time, God will come and bring it to pass. The Bible says in the book of Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 3, for the vision is at an appointed time. It shall not tarry, but it shall come to pass. Just like how the vision is going to come to pass, the promise of God is going to come. The dream that you may be having, oh God must have given you a dream, is going to come. He says, at the appointed time, it will come to pass, my brother and sister. Hold on to God. Hold on to the feet of Jesus like Mary. Martha was busy in the world. Martha was trying to do her best in looking after the guests that came to her. When the master was there, instead of drawing attention to the master, she was drawing attention to the people. That's what is happening. Instead of drawing attention to the master, you are busy with your own life. You are busy with the things of this world. But whereas Mary drew the attention of the master, she was at the feet of Jesus, listening to Jesus what he was saying. He was listening to Jesus, my brother and sister in Christ. Amen. And that's why Martha was, Mary was blessed. Why Mary was blessed? Because she was at the feet of Jesus, listening. That's why I'll tell you something, my brother, my sister in Christ. You must allow yourself to be ministered by the Lord. You must allow yourself to be ministered by God if you want to be used by God. Hallelujah. Because once you're ministered by God, that's when God will download His wisdom and knowledge and understanding inside you, that you will be ready to do the work of God. That's what He was able to do in the life of the disciples. For 40 days He was teaching them about the kingdom of God. And after that, 10 days in the upper room, they continued to pray for the outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
My brother and sister in Christ, 50 days, 50 days of training, 40 days of teaching, and 10 days of prayer with fasting shook the entire Jerusalem, shook entire Israel, the ordinary people, just like you and me. But today, God looks into your heart. That's why you must allow yourself to be ministered by God, to have an effective ministry. And that's what the Lord is telling today. Let not fear come into your heart. Let not fear enter into your heart of what is happening at the moment. Do not look at the things, sir. Do not look at those things, sir, which bring fear in your heart.
Amen.
But look upon God, the author and the finisher of the faith. Meditate upon the word of God. Because the Bible says in Romans 10:17, for faith comes by hearing and listening to the word of God. Meditate, for God is in the business of speaking to His children.
Amen.
God is in the business of speaking to you, my brother and sister. Whoever is watching this video, do not ignore, because God is in control. God is in control of everything, that whatever you are doing. He is not the one who will leave you, nor will He forsake you, because He has carved you on the palm of His hand. The Bible says He has carved you on the palm of His hand. He is the one who will sustain you in Psalm 3 verse 5. He is the one who is concerned over your life. In Psalm 138 verse 8, the Bible says He is concerned over you. He is worried about you, my brother and sister in Christ. Every minute and every second in life. That's what happened to the prodigal son. When the prodigal son left the home and went away, the father was always worried about his son. And that's what today, my brother and sister in Christ, you may be like a prodigal son and a prodigal woman. You must have left God because your faith has been tested. Because you're going through trials, because you're going through persecution. You must have left God and became like a prodigal son and a prodigal daughter. But the Lord is worried. He's just looking at you. When will you come back to Him? The father every day went at the crossroad looking for the prodigal son. That he was worried. He was not worried about the eldest son, but he was worried for the second son. Every day he used to go to the crossroad to see that this prodigal son who left me and went away, that one day he will come back. My brother and sister, his hope was not in vain. The father's hope was not in vain. And one day he saw his son coming back. My brother and sister, today we may be like the same prodigal son and the prodigal daughter. We have lost our way. We have lost our contact with God, my brother. Because instead of having contact with God, we are having contact with this world and with many people over there. We are filling up our WhatsApp messages and our WhatsApp with numbers of contact. That contact you don't require, my brother and sister. What you require, the contact of Jesus you require. So the prodigal son, when he realized his mistake, he came back to the father, because the father was worried. The father was worried about what is happening to the son. And today, my brother, my sister, God is concerned over your life. You may be thinking, oh, no one loves me. No one cares for me. Oh, I am just left as an orphan. But the word of God says in the book of John, it says in the book of John chapter 14 verse 19, I will never leave you as orphan. I will never leave you as orphan, but I will send you my comforter, my helper, my Holy Spirit, which shall be with you, which shall abide with you, and which shall lead you in all truth. Brother and sister in Christ, today, as you're watching this live message which has been come in the Facebook, I want to thank our brother who has asked me to do this Facebook live. Normally, I am not a person to come on live, but what the Lord has said, that is what I speak. And may the Lord has blessed your soul who is watching this video. And not only just watch this video, please share this video that it may edify the body of Christ. Hallelujah. Because the Bible says that whatever we do, do it for the glory of God, that God be glorified. He must increase and we must decrease. The Bible says, humble yourself under the mighty hand of the Lord. In the day I will exalt you. Hallelujah. Because the high and the lofty one dwells in the humble, broken and contrite in spirit. Hallelujah. God bless you. Amen.